If you don't have time to grind, and you want to buy a stacked account in 2K with max badges, a nice record, and a high overall, head up sportstnb.com. The link is on the screen, and you can find the link in both the comment section and in the description.
The Nets are some goddamn gangsters, bro. No. Listen to me. The Nets are some goddamn gangsters, bro. Oh my goodness. Let me just take this one from the top. We spent this whole season talking about KD and Kyrie to the Knicks. I've seen countless photoshops of Kyrie and KD in Knicks jerseys. When the Knicks traded Kristaps Porzingis and cleared cap space, and I heard, I believe it was James Dolan or somebody in Knicks management say that they had already had assurances from top free agents. That really, to us, meant Kyrie Irving, Kevin Durant, and they signed with the next door neighbors. This would be the equivalent of if the Clippers would have been the ones to get Anthony Davis and then maybe Kawhi Leonard. That's what this is. Oh, they some goddamn gangsters, bro. Oh, that's not even the whole thing here. They're also signing DeAndre Jordan. Yes, nobody's locking him in the house this time. No chairs are blocking the door. All in one night, the Nets are going to go from a team that was just a first round out to a team with two of the top free agents this summer and a very good center. What they plan to do between DJ and Jared Allen, I have no clue, but that's not the topic of this video. Let's start from the top. So, I don't know if we have any confirmation that Draymond Green ever actually told Kevin Durant to bounce and said, we don't need you. But if he did, Kevin Durant took his advice, and he turned down what was going to be like a $220 million offer from the Golden State Warriors. That's particularly fascinating to me because I didn't think that there was a better basketball situation out there for Kevin Durant basketball-wise because he's just ruptured his Achilles, obviously. We know that players have a very difficult time with that, even the best of them. And the whole thing I was thinking was, especially because it looks like the Lakers might be putting Kawhi Leonard with Anthony Davis and LeBron James, that is three maybe top five players arguably on the same team. I thought, okay, KD can come back to this team in 2021 and be playing with Steph Curry and Klay Thompson and whoever else, and that's probably still one of the best teams. And on top of that, they were offering him, again, $220 million to do so. Being on a team with those two after you've ruptured your Achilles, I just thought that that was very attractive because your usage won't have to be so high. A team isn't going to be leaning on you so much to go compete. But you know what? Maybe the ruptured Achilles, maybe it really sparked something inside KD because you already know he cares what people think. And the whole season, I really think the whole narrative this year was this being his last season with Golden State because he would want to go rebuild his image and prove that he could win without a super team and all that good stuff. And maybe the ruptured Achilles made him even hungrier because now that's a comeback story. So going with the Nets, going with Kyrie, obviously that you're still with another star, which who would expect you not to be, but that's not anything close to what he had in Golden State. That's not a surefire all-star team, always going to the finals, always going to win type thing. But KD to the Nets was kind of given away. If you follow me on Twitter, that was my prediction. I tweeted out yesterday, actually. I thought it was going to be the Nets. And to me, the dead giveaway was how the Nets were treating the Kyrie Irving situation. See, there's no doubt that Kyrie Irving is better than D'Angelo Russell, but here's the thing. We know that Kyrie has had problems with two teams now. Well, really one. Boston is where all the real, like, problems were, like, all season kind of out there in the open. With Cleveland, it was more of just a breakup. But, okay, there's questions there. Then there's definitely questions about his health as well, because the knee is a recurring thing. So, you're making a huge investment in a player that you might lose by February or before the playoffs or whatever. And with the Nets having gone through this rebuild and becoming a playoff team led by D'Angelo Russell, I was constantly thinking to myself, this doesn't make sense. It doesn't make sense for them to be putting themselves through this trouble to just replace D'Angelo Russell, because while Kyrie is an amazing player, he himself does not just go to the Nets and turn them into a contending team. And so then why would you risk all the money on a guy who might be injured? And then you have someone in D'Angelo who doesn't have really any problems right now. The whole thing that happened in Los Angeles that's behind him that has not followed him throughout his career. So it just seemed like a lot of trouble to replace a really good player for not a lot of reasons. So that's when I thought, okay, they have to be going through this trouble. They have to be because they know that someone's coming with him. And who could that someone have been? Kyrie Irving and KD have been tied together this whole season. And so to me, that was the giveaway. That's why that was my pick yesterday. And that's also why I'm not exactly surprised. You're always kind of like crazy when something actually happens, but I'm also not that surprised. Also, not that surprised Kevin Durant has left Golden State, because although it was a very difficult situation to leave, you can understand it. He won two championships by going to the Warriors, championships that most people do not respect. It was not a difficult thing to go to that team that had already won a championship and that was already very, very good, already had one of the better cores that we'd seen in a while. It wasn't a challenge. It wasn't competitive. And so for him to stay in Golden State before he ruptured his Achilles for five more years, that's why a lot of people thought he was going to leave, because we were like, what if he wins and, you know, X amount of championships here? What is that really going to do for his career when, you know, no one's ever going to really respect it? And he doesn't seem like he respects them himself. You got the team joking on you at the parade and stuff like that. I mean, we all know it wasn't lighthearted fun, but still, that was there's truth to every joke, right? You know what I'm talking about with Bob Myers, and they were talking about the money that was earned and all that. There's some truth in every joke. Then you got the Draymond situation that happened. There's just so much with the situation where it's like it's a perfect basketball situation, but there was another step in his career that he could take, and I'm happy he's done it. I'm very excited to see it at the start of the 2021 season, because it, just in case you've forgotten all this excitement, KD's not going to play this year. He is not going to play this year. We will not see any of this come to fruition until 2021, so this is on the back burner, but nevertheless, it's still a big move when arguably the best player in the NBA, your second best player in the NBA, switches teams like this. And that's the other crazy part about this, right? When we knew it was an Achilles injury, it had to cross your mind for a second, like, whoa, that's a career altering injury. So what are teams, you know, what are they going to do this summer? But of course, again, if you're a team like the Nets and you're never mentioned with contending, and you haven't contended in how long? The Nets haven't contended since the Jason Kidd days. Oh my goodness, it's like 2002, I was in the second grade. So regardless, if KD had one leg, you still probably offer him the max. But with all this being said, it's obviously disappointing that we don't get to see this play out for another year, because what's going on in LA is very interesting. Say Kawhi Leonard goes to the Clippers instead of the Lakers, obviously that would be amazing, because Clippers have a good supporting cast. I'm sure they would get someone else with him. Then you got Lakers, Clippers, and you would have the Nets. And now let's keep our eyes peeled for what happens with Kawhi, because another interesting thing I'm taking from this is yesterday it was just being reported that Kawhi and KD were talking about ways they could play together, and I believe that was really only going to happen on the Knicks or the Clippers, because the Nets, they were really locked in with Kyrie. The fact that KD went ahead and he was planning on announcing this at 6 o'clock. He was going to do that today. That's as free agency opens. So maybe he knows what Kawhi is up to, and that means, you know, maybe him and Kawhi's plans just didn't work out, or Kawhi maybe planned to go to the Lakers, because obviously then KD can't join him there. Or he plans to stay in Toronto. That's another video. I'm not going to get into the Kawhi business here, because I expect that to explode not too long from now. And shout out to the NBA for being restored, at least for the moment. For the moment, the Golden State dynasty is officially over. Because the thing that was going to happen here, they were going to offer KD 5 years, so they're already signing Klay Thompson. That means KD, Steph, and Klay. That was going to be a thing going into the middle of the 2020s. So we would have missed a season of them, but then they probably would have come right back and dropped the hammer if they're not going to have recurring injuries. Now KD is gone, he has ended that phase of the NBA, and it's kind of hard to imagine something like the Warriors could happen again, because, well, I'm going to save this, because that's actually going to be a big conversation. If Kawhi does go to the Lakers, what would be worse? Kawhi, AD, and LeBron, or what Golden State had? Because I'll just say some of it here. Obviously, Golden State shooting, that was one of the things that made them so lethal. And it was also the fact with the Warriors, most of the time, it was like a big four. So the question becomes, three potential top five players on the same team, but not a great supporting cast. Or a team like you had with the Warriors, who still had they had a core four, three of those being top players. And then Iggy and Sean Livingston off the bench. That's a completely different conversation. So while we're on the subject of the Warriors, what happens now? I was just watching the Warriors Super Team video from Bleacher Report that they posted when KD first signed there. The one where they're like vampires and Halloween. And I was just thinking about how, man, back then we all saw more than two rings for this team. And everything just changed blindingly fast for them, bro. They were just, they just had Cousins and KD and Klay and Steph. And they were handling the Rockets without KD, and didn't look like they would ever lose once they get KD back. And now they're sitting here without Klay Thompson until probably March, because he just tore his ACL, and KD completely gone. Now, this, if you're looking for a silver lining here, one thing that's cool for the Warriors is that maybe now they don't just have to completely throw away next season. You still got Steph, you still got Draymond, and you're expecting Klay back. One of the One of the pitfalls of their situation was that they were going to have to sit Klay most of the year and KD all of the year, yet they were going to be on the payroll. So, in essence, you were going to be just wasting a year of Steph Curry's prime. He was going to be out there scoring 30 every night, but who were they about to sign in the place of Klay and KD not being there all year to even keep them competitive, to even really get them to the playoffs? It's the Western Conference, right? They could have easily not made the playoffs this year. Well, at least for right now, without Kevin Durant, they were planning to offer him a max. He's not going to be there now. What do they do? You've given Klay his money. He's going to stay. They can probably work some things out this year in free agency so that they can be competitive next year, so that they can even try to make a run, because again, if they look competitive and look like they're going to be in the playoffs, Klay will probably be back for that. If he's back in March, he's got some time to at least try. You know, he's there to shoot. He's there for 3 and D. I'm not sure his defense is going to catch back up immediately, but his shooting probably will. He's a standstill shooter. So at least this kind of clears the situation up for them, and they should probably be thanking Kevin Durant that he made this decision so fast. This decision came, it broke on the internet before the decision, you know, before his show in the boardroom. And so now the Warriors have all the free agency to look and kind of move dominoes into place, do what they got to do, and they can still be pretty competitive next year probably, as opposed to where it looked like they were just going to, and it looked like they were willing to throw an entire season away and come back in 2021 with the death squad. But now things get very interesting though, because something I've been discussing all throughout the season in preparation for Kevin Durant possibly leaving is looking at the career of Steph Curry. You saw it when Steph missed that shot at the end of the Toronto game, the one that basically closed the whole series out. He had a very good look at it, and the conversation comes up like, why does Steph never hit the biggest shot of the game? He could be very clutch in the last 5 minutes or whatever, but that last shot that is going to decide a very big moment. You got 2016 now where he couldn't do it. You got 2019. And I always knew once Kevin Durant left, people are going to question him, because they're going to say these last few years with Kevin Durant, they were easy. Let's go ahead and call it what it was. That was an all-star team. That was easy. The space on the floor for everybody was as good as it will probably ever be. So now KD is gone. Now we are entering the 2020s. I am very interested to follow Steph Curry and the evolution of his career, because I think he probably is still going to be wanting to prove some things. Last time we saw him without, an amazing super team was 2016. Now we're picking back up where that left off, in my opinion, and expect Golden State to be right there in the thick of things going forward, because they showed they made the finals. They beat the Rockets without KD, went to the NBA Finals, and they were one shot away from a 7-game series with the Raptors. So now you still got that core. You got Klay Thompson, you got Draymond, you got Curry. Now you can build a good supporting cast again, and I am so excited to see what the future holds for them, because this isn't the part where they just fade to the background. Maybe they aren't going to be like the overseers over the league like they've been for the last 2 years, but whatever happens this season, it might be a little rough, but we have not seen the last of the Warriors. I feel pretty confident in saying that. But as of right now, yeah, you know, this is a Nets video, but we're not so much looking at what's going to happen with them, because this season it's just going to be Kyrie and the Nets. Just, I don't know, this is going to be one of the weirdest seasons we've watched with the team, right? Because when have we watched a team sign one of the best players in the NBA, but they are not able to play there all season? So like when the Nets get eliminated, you kind of looking at them like, uh-oh, watch out for them next year. And the whole season, you know, that's going to be on the back burner. That's just going to feel really weird. And because of that, there's really no sense in even discussing what next season looks like after this move, because so much is going to change between now and the time we actually see KD and Kyrie play together. So that is the first big domino of free agency. Now we look to Jimmy Butler, we look to Kawhi Leonard. Still some really, really big things that could happen. We are not done yet, so stay tuned. Hit the like button, comment, and sub, and hit the bell next to the channel name. Stay up to date when the next domino falls. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all in the next one.